Welcome to the channel today, guys. Today we're going to be talking about why I sold some Virgin Galactic stock here. And before you guys get too upset at me, I did not sell all of my stock. I felt like I had a bit of an overweight position, and I felt like this is a good time to exit some of my position. So we're going to go ahead and dive into why Virgin Galactic just recently cracked through that $30 mark. We're going to be diving into that. And we're also going to be diving into why I sold a little bit of my shares right now. I still have a decent position, but I did sell some of my shares in Virgin Galactic, and I want to share with you why. So if you enjoy the content, I do cover Virgin Galactic a little bit more because this is still one of my heavier positions. So if you want to follow, go ahead and follow for that. And let's dive into why I sold some of my Virgin Galactic stock. So first, let's go ahead and provide a little bit of backstory for why I sold some of this. So we had our failed rocket test where the rocket failed to ignite and then they landed safely, which was good, but I thought it was kind of an overreaction. So before that test had happened, it had climbed up into the low 30s, and which I was happy about because I had a decent chunk of shares or whatnot, and then that test didn't go exactly right and then fell about 20% or 25% that week alone. So at that point, I had purchased some more shares. I doubled up on my position because I thought, well, this seems like it fell way too much. And I feel like once they announce that there's going to be another rocket test, it's going to climb up and up and up again in anticipation. And then I can sell these shares before the test, because if there is another failure, even a small one, I think it's going to crush the share price, which we'll get into a little bit later. But even if there's a huge one, it's going to absolutely demolish the share price. But anyway, so they had the failed test, they dropped like 25% that 1 week, and then I scooped up and doubled my position on my shares. So I sold it once it got past 30, because it had gotten past 30 before and I had made a decent amount of money. So I sold all of those additional shares that I had bought. Why did I not hang on to those is what we're going to get into. So it shot past 30 for a couple of reasons though. So Kathy Wood from ARK, she's got ETFs that she provides. ARK is her main one. She is now going to be making a space ETF, and Virgin Galactic is going to be in it, which I think is great. And I think Virgin Galactic's on the cutting edge of space travel, and everything they're doing I think is really, really cool. Obviously, otherwise I wouldn't be invested in them. Also on 1/7, Virgin Galactic tweeted that they found the problem and they are currently working on it right now. So that is why it shot past 30 recently. So now I'm just wanting to dive into a little bit of the bull thesis and the bear thesis, which I think points on both sides of these are accurate, but I also think that one should look at both sides of the argument before they go into an investment, otherwise you don't see all the sides of the investment. So the bulls. I believe the bulls, I'm still a bull on this stock, so I believe that it getting part of this ETF is great. I'm hoping they're going to have a successful test launch. I'm hoping that that's going to elevate the share price, and I think that's going to be great. I'm still have my bullish thesis where I'm hoping Branson goes up still next quarter or so, and then we start bringing people up and start earning some revenue. That's the bull thesis. That's what I'm hoping happens. But I can also kind of see the bears in this one right now too. So price-wise, I feel like it's a bit ahead of itself, and I think bears would think this, and I also feel it also is a bit ahead of itself. It rose to 32 in anticipation that it was going to have a successful test flight. This time it's announced that it's part of an ETF, which is great, and that the rocket failure is being fixed currently, which is also still pretty good news. The good news, I feel at least, is kind of getting priced in right now. I'm not sure how much more it could run up once they do announce that they're going to be having another test flight. I'm also not sure when that test flight is. They haven't really told us if it's going to be sooner, later. Is it going to be weeks again? I feel like if he announced it's going to be a month away, that's another month away that my bull thesis is going to take to pan out, and that's another month of cash burn, and it's just not something I think is very ideal. So also, no Virgin Galactic test yet, and no tweeting on any time that there's going to be a test. So the longer you leave your investors hanging out in the wind, I feel like we're going to get a little bit antsy and people are going to start jumping ship, you know, things like that. Which is kind of what I did, I guess, with a little bit of my shares. A failure. So this stock is also kind of scary because I feel like there's limited upside and there's very, very big downside. So if there's a catastrophic failure, or there was just a minor failure and the shares fell 25%, we got to keep that in mind. If there's a huge failure, like a crash, then this share, I would guess 50-75% is going to get shaved off the top of this stock, because then it's going to reset where they are with basically everything. So I feel like there is a limited upside and a very, very heavy downside. So now we'll dive into specifically why I sold half my shares here. So why I sold some of my Virgin Galactic stock, half of it to be specific. And this is the chunk that I bought right after the failed test, because I felt that it had fallen too far after the failed test and I thought it would be a quick fix. Quite honestly, I thought they would have launched again by now and done another test, which has not happened yet. So that's another point why I've sold, because I feel like they're kind of dragging their feet on keeping us well informed. But anyway, let's get to the points. So 10% holdings. So I generally, in my portfolio, only have about 10% of one stock in my holdings. This one had grown to about 20% of my holdings, and I was not really comfortable with that myself, just for risk management. Because if they have a test flight, and then the share price cuts off 75%, then 20% of my portfolio is going to get absolutely just blown apart, which is not ideal, obviously. So I didn't like the amount of risk that we were into that. So now we've cut back down to about 10% holdings, where I feel comfortable with the amount of risk that's involved if something bad were to happen. Failure would crush the shares. We already covered this. I feel like if there is a small failure or even a big failure, we're at least going to see a 30% drop in the next test flight. Or even if we have to wait, I feel we're also going to see a significant drop if we have to wait another month, because then the whole bull thesis gets pushed out again, another quarter probably, if we have to wait a month or another 2 months. So Branson going up Q1, that's not going to happen now. Now it's going to be Q2, but if it gets pushed out further, it's going to be Q3 now. They have a decent amount of cash burn that's just going to keep stacking up month and month and month. Like, it's just not an ideal situation. So I was not pleased that I keep seeing my bullish thesis get pushed back. I still think it's going to happen, and I still believe when Branson goes up into space, when they bring that first group of people up into space, this thing's going to light like a rocket. But I just feel that I need a little bit of downside protection in this one myself. So my thesis was pushed back. We just covered that. Taking fast profits. So I had made money fairly quickly on this one, just having the stock from the time where it had fallen after the failed test to where it popped up from Cathie Wood and ARK's announcement, where they're above $30 again. So I still have half my position, but I just took some quick profits and I can shove it into something that's maybe a little bit less risky, or just have a little bit of cash reserves because everything's kind of expensive right now. So I still have some skin in the game. I still have my original chunk of shares that I have. I'm still very bullish on this one. I do believe that Branson's going to go up this year at some point, hopefully Q2. And then I do believe that they're going to be bringing passengers up and still making revenue in 2021 this year here. So still very bullish on it. Just wanted some downside protection. So that's what I got for you guys here today. If you enjoy the content, think about subscribing. And hopefully you guys make a ton of money. Hopefully we all do on Virgin Galactic.